I love a bit of smart tech, and today I'm going to be checking out these Elite Nero smart rollers that they've kindly sent in. But why? Well, firstly, these rollers are nothing like your traditional ones. Instead, they've got automatically controlled variable resistance in them, which makes them a genuine alternative, in my opinion, to the ever popular direct drive turbo trainer that people are using on virtual reality worlds such as Zwift. Having used rollers for literally decades, I was very excited for these to land on my desk. But firstly, let's actually explain what rollers are. Well, they're a freestanding product. They allow you to ride your bike just like a turbo trainer, but well, with a pretty obvious difference to it. The difference is you're not supported in any way at all when you're riding on the rollers, whereas on a turbo trainer, you're clamped into position. So you rely on balance, speed, and battling against gravity to stay upright. It's just like, well, riding a bike. Now these rollers, they actually only share a couple of similarities to the rollers which we would see riders using way back in the 1960s until almost the present day. And that is that there's three rollers actually in them in total. So you've got two here at the rear that your rear wheel sits between, and then the front one here, which is driven by these two bands. So as you're cycling away, your back wheel propels the front one, and you've almost got like a virtual rolling road as you're going along. So it's, well, just giving you that road-like feel. And then a recent addition into these rollers, which is super cool, is the 2.7 kilogram flywheels in each rear roller. So you're carrying a certain inertia and momentum, if you like, just like riding on the open road. If there's one thing rollers does, it gives you that feeling. Now, with all this out of the way, let's get onto the smart bits of tech then. They are a smart roller after all. Well, firstly, you can connect them via Ant Plus or Bluetooth to either your computer or a smartphone, meaning that you can ride your indoor cycling worlds or any pre-planned workouts, and the resistance adjusts accordingly. So, depending on the terrain you're riding on or any pre-planned efforts you've got set, these will do the job for you. Now, how is that done exactly? Well, it's via magnetic force within these rear roller drums. So the harder the terrain, the stronger that magnetic force is going to be, and the easier, well, the less force is going to be. So it's all going to adjust accordingly. Now, the resistance can work in conjunction or independently from another great feature of these rollers, which is the ability to simulate riding on a gradient of up to 7%, which is probably enough for most of us out there. This truly turns a pair of rollers into a training aid that I feel can compete with any other out there. Combined with the fact that you can ride at up to 1,350 watts at 60k an hour, I think it's time we bring in a special guest to run through more of the great features. Right, good to have my main man Hank here now to actually run through a few of the different features on it. First up then, let's actually explain that the Nero smart rollers are adjustable. So if you've got a really long mountain bike or a really short road bike, well, you're catered for, because there's 11 different adjustment positions just down here that you can extend the rollers in order to get the best riding position. Of course, for maximum comfort and, well, smoothness when riding, you want to have the front axle either over the center of that front roller or just to the back of it. So you've got a little bit of room there to play around with. But well, with no further ado, mate, I think it's about time you took a step up, quite literally. The Neros have actually got a handy little fold down step which make getting on and off of the rollers a lot easier, because normally, well, we've got a couple of inches, haven't we, James, to actually, you know, the bike's elevated more than normal, and it's not necessarily that simple, is it, to actually get started?
No, it's you're kind of off balance before you even get on, so having that step just brings you to a level where you can sit on the saddle and get the pedals going without too much trouble.
Yeah.
So you're not relying on maybe a friend or a wall to help you.
Now, one thing that many riders find and feel when they first get on a pair of rollers is that they have a bouncing type feel rather than a circular motion of pedaling. So the reason for that being is that rollers actually subconsciously teach you to pedal in circles, because it makes the ride quality a lot better. So many of the best riders in the world who have souplesse, so a real smooth pedaling action, is normally actually because they've grown up using rollers. So think of riders like Elio Kaiser, Bradley Wiggins, Frank Vandenbroucke, guys like that. They had such smooth pedaling actions, and it would have almost certainly come because of this. Plus, if you don't have that natural smooth pedaling style, which, well, I'm not blessed with, I don't know about you, are you blessed with that or not?
Probably not, mate, given my style.
The great thing is that Elite have actually incorporated something called quick motion into the rollers. Now, what this means is that the rollers themselves actually rock backwards and forwards very, very slightly. So you can see here that when James is doing that, they're kind of taking up any of that imbalance or sort of unnatural pedaling style, so that he can still ride along in, well, comfort, really. Have you ever ridden on anything like this before with the
I mean, it feels a lot
movement.
More comfortable with this floating, and you don't end up rolling on top of the roller.
Yeah.
it keeps you in the nice stable state where you can basically just concentrate on your riding and not too much about your balance and kind of where you're sitting on the roller.
What about then getting out of the saddle? Because on a pair of normal rollers, well, it's not very easy, is it?
It's not. So with these, when you get out of the saddle, without your rear wheel flying off the back as it would on a fixed pair of rollers, that slack's taken up by the float of the rollers.
Yeah.
So you can find it a lot easier to stretch your legs, basically.
Yeah. Because that is something you tend to find, isn't it, really, when you're riding on rollers for quite a long time, is you do tend to get a little bit sore here and there, purely just because you're in one position. I mean, not, you know, when you're out on the road, you're always moving around and stuff.
Yeah, that's correct. It's like riding a piece of flat road, you know, for about, for an hour on end.
Yeah.
You do want to get out the saddle, stretch your legs, get a bit of blood flow going before you settle back in, yeah, and crank up the power.
Yeah. Now you say that about riding on a flat road for an hour on end, but well, we've got it linked up here, haven't we, right now to Zwift. And well, you're riding up a 6% gradient right now.
And to be honest, John, I can definitely feel it.
Exactly, you got out of the saddle just at the right time to demonstrate.
Might need to get back out.
Yeah. And also, the actual rollers themselves are parabolically shaped, so at the edges, they're shaped in such a way, if you were to drift over there, it kind of gently nudges you back in the right direction, doesn't it?
It does indeed. So if I try and demonstrate...
It's quite hard, isn't it, to demonstrate it when you...
Well, it's harder.
Yeah, but there we are, you know, he's... Yeah.
So it basically just puts you back into the middle. So your rollers want you to sit in the middle of where it's more stable and it's easier to ride than right on the edge.
Yeah. And I mean, for us, rollers, traditionally, they were used really as like a, you'd hone your pedaling technique, wouldn't you? Or maybe use them for a little warm up or something like that. But I mean, you can see now, linked up to Zwift, you're going up an 8% climb right now. That's adjusting in the actual resistance of the rollers too. I can see by a couple of beads of sweat coming down.
I'm getting out of breath, John.
It is actually, you know, I never thought I would say that rollers, you would be able to use them as a viable training, you know, alternative for a turbo trainer for like those real hard intervals. Mm. But I think with this, I'm really, really like pleasantly surprised. Right, there we are. I'm gonna leave Hank to this because, well,
I'm in a session.
Yeah, you are, aren't you? You've really started to enjoy this.
Yeah.
It's great. We're not gonna be getting any more filming done for today.
No.
Right, so remember to like and share this video with your friends and keep your eyes peeled on the channel because we've got a couple of pairs of these to be giving away soon.
Ooh.
So that's good news for someone out there, isn't it?
That is for sure. And if you get hold of them, let us know if you what you think in the comment section below.
Yeah. Remember also to check out the GCN shop at shop.globalcyclingnetwork.com. Got a whole heap of new goodies, including this brand new Cobbled Classics t-shirt, riding kit, you name it, we've got it. And now for two more great videos, how about clicking just down here and just over here.
Right, John, can you get me a towel now?
Yeah, do you want a drink?
Oh, desperate.
You're going well, mate, you're going well. Setting me some new PBs.
Yeah.
All